If you want a quick, brutal lesson on Europe's debt crisis, just ask an Irish property developer. Simon Kelly was one of the biggest in Dublin. Today, he's bust. His business is over $600 million in the red. And much of the empire he and his father built along the Liffey River is in the hands of the government agency managing Ireland's debt-ridden property assets.
Well, certainly our two over there are in the asset management agency. But as we switch again to the south side here, this big office block here is, this one up here is as well. We've developed a hotel there behind it, which is partially with the agency. And as we move down the quays, we've constructed a second office building there, but the majority of buildings around us would be in the agency. So the agency is to manage all of this real estate.
So all this real estate is basically...
Nationalised.
Nationalised.
Yeah, at this stage. Or as good as.
And how much of asset values dropped? How much of property values dropped?
Down here, these brand new buildings have still dropped 50%.
Wow.
You know.
Every day I try to salvage some of my pride, to find some work so as I might pay my way. But everywhere I go, the answer's always no. There's no work for any man here today.
It's been well over a year since Ireland was bailed out of its debt crisis by the European Union and the IMF. But today, unemployment is stuck over 14% and youth unemployment is double this. The Irish economy is showing few signs of life and the Irish government is mired in debt.
No work today.
Many Irish are asking whether the tough austerity measures demanded by the bailout are curing them or making them worse.
Our hospitals are under threat of closure, our schools are being affected, our education service and health service are really badly affected. People who need help aren't getting it. We are developing a very unfair and unequal society. I want fairness in society and I want my children to have a future here, and I don't see that happening right now.
Ever since the debt crisis began, this anger has echoed in protests across Europe. Behind it lies fraught questions. How much do ordinary citizens endure in cuts to wages, pensions and services to pay for the massive credit binge that left banks and European governments from Ireland to Greece awash with bad debts? And how much will investors share the burden? Ireland has repeatedly received the painful message: unless taxpayers foot the bill for its huge debts, global financial markets won't lend to its banks or its government except at impossibly high interest rates. It's a message being pounded out to countries across Europe as the great debt crisis heads into its second dangerous year.